Hi everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Cordell Felix, and on this video I will show you how to make two types of reflection materials in the Unreal Development Kit. This is great for adding reflection to your models with either an environment cube map or a tileable texture. I will be using the November 2012 build of UDK for this video, and this video assumes that you have a basic knowledge of UDK and its material editor. I'm going to be using my warehouse environment to demonstrate adding the cube map reflection, and I will quickly show you how to set up a generic reflection like this cube on the right. On the left, I have a cube that reflects the environment. As you can see, at the top, you can see the roof. In the backside, you can see the doors that I had. And I have this cube on the right that reflects a tileable texture that I have to fake a metal look. Now I'm back at when I first started to make the environment cube map. You're going to want your environment to be a little interesting so that the scene capture actor can pull the detail from it. You'll be able to see whatever is currently in your level in the cube map texture. We need to go to the content browser, and we can do that by clicking this little black square icon at the top here. And I need you to go to the actor classes and then the uncategorized drop-down list here. And if you go to the scene capture cube act actor and you just drag that right into your environment, it should be right on top of you. So if you go into your environment back out a little bit, you need to be in editor mode. So hit G, it could be hiding, and just drag that in there. So you get this big sphere. This sphere is just an actor that allows us to render out a cube map of our environment and put it into a texture. You're going to want to put this in a good spot so that way you're capturing most of the environment as best as you can. Like right now I have it too close to the ground, I think, and it's not directly center of the room as to where I want it to capture mostly everything. So you want it kind of in a spot like this. If you're in more of an outdoor environment, you should put it more in the middle of your level somewhere. And so this is good because it's not too close to the ground, so we'll be capturing too much ground or the roof. So it'll be just right. Just make sure you put it in a spot like that. I'm going to go back into the content browser, and I'm going to be creating a new texture. So I'm going to go into my textures package and right click, and then create new texture render target cube. This is just give me a new texture that I'm going to be plugging into the actor we just put in. So I'm going to name this environment. And I'm going to give it a size of 512. This will just give me better quality of the reflections. And you don't really need to mess with this format. Click OK. It all looks good. Now we need to plug this texture render target cube into the actor that we added in earlier. So I'm going to minimize this. And actually, now I'm going to keep that up. Let's just bring it over here because I need to have them clicked. And I'm going to hit F4 to go into the properties of this. And I'm going to plug this texture into this green arrow here. Now you see that this sphere kind of turns into like a mirror. That's the reflections. So one thing to note is that the far plane is a 500, and that we can't really see the sky or anything. So now if it's at like 300, you can't really see much. So we need to set this to max so that we can get the entire sky in there. With that plugged in now, we need to go back to the content browser and then right click on this texture that we just plugged in, and then click create new static texture. And I'll just leave it as that. And click OK, and it's going to render out five different textures for us that all create a cube map. Click out and go back in, and there we go. There's your cube map right there. Oh, actually, that's six maps that it rendered out for us. Cool. We need to plug this guy into a material now, so I'm going to go to the materials and just create a new material. I have one already created, but I'll create a new one to show you how it works. So let's go to right-click, create new material. And let's just call this m_reflection_cube_map02, because I already have one. Alright. We need to add three things to get this to work. So there's a reflection vector, a vector transform, and the cube map that we need to drag in here. So first I'm going to add the reflection, so I'm just going to type in REF to get the reflection vector, click and drag that in. Zoom out a bit. And there's their vector transform, so I'm going to type in transform, or TRA. There we go. Let's plug him in. And now I need to drag in my cube map that I rendered out earlier, so this guy. So I'll click drag, and there we go. And let's put this in the back of the UVs. And if I put this into emissive, it should now pop up and you can see the cube map. So from anywhere I look, you can see the environment. Now that he's done, I'm just going to click the green arrow, and he's good to go. I'm going to create a copy of this guy now, so you go back here. And I'm going to create a copy of this material, and I'll just name it Reflection Simple. Now this material is different because it's using a different texture sample. This is using this environment cube map texture, and this vector transform doesn't support that. Only a mask with a reflection can support a tileable texture. So I'm going to delete this vector transform and the texture sample, and I'm going to drag in a mask. I'm going to type in mask and drag in this component mask. And now I need my tileable texture. So I'm going to go into my content browser, and I'm going to go to my textures. And I have this already imported. It's just like a fake sky reflection sort of thing. It looked nice and metal to me, so I made it tileable. So I'm going to drag him in here. And let's minimize this. And I'm going to plug these all in. This into emissive. And there you go. You can see that it's tileable, it works nice, and it takes kind of a metal look. I would suggest adding a bit more nodes or parameters to make these techniques a little bit more appealing, because right now it's literally just a mirror and you don't want to work with that really. What I would do is I would multiply or add a metal texture to this, so that way you get some of that metal detail going on in the texture. I would add a mask, so that way I could mask out areas that are rubber, because you don't want your rubber to look like metal, you want your metal to look like metal. So one way to do that is to get some of that reflective in it. And I would also add a Fresnel in there, so that way I can have some darker edges and some brighter insides. And I would control a parameter, or I would have a parameter to control the intensity of that also. I have an example of that already in my environment on one of my truck containers. I have the reflectiveness on there, but it's not so apparent that I have the diffuse leaking through, so it looks nice. I noticed that I still have this actor in my environment, and once you render out the cube map, you don't really need it anymore, so you can just delete it. I use the reflection cube technique on this truck here. You can see the reflection of the other truck on the metal areas, and that places where there is dirt, it has no reflection. Masking out dirt and scratches from your reflections is a great way to make your props look awesome. That's it for this quick tip. My name is Cordell Felix, and thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.